I am here with Yuri Makovetsky, who is a dancer, and he is from New York, but he is dancing with Alicia Phillips, who is from the UK, so he's representing the UK. He's been a semi-finalist of the UK Closed and a quarter-finalist in the Worlds in Dublin. And he's also one of my ambassadors, of course. and since we're talking about well-being this 1 month, I thought it would be really nice to bring him in because Yuri has done a lot of things that is really good for well-being. And I just think it would be nice if you could like share it and also how it kind of helps with his dancing and his life in general. So hi, Yuri.
Hi, everyone. Yes. So firstly, thank you so much, Christina, for this opportunity. It's amazing. And ever since I've been an ambassador of Coach Ballroom, I've been able to do the things that I am doing with well-being more and more. And I've just been motivated more. So thank you so much. But well-being is huge. For me, I used to be very, very overweight when I was younger. And demotivated most of the time. And then I kind of find myself motivated and on track when I am dancing, but also in life when I do something like a morning routine. So my morning routine is very interesting in a way. I've been doing a lot of research. I've been doing a lot of reading and all of that kind of good stuff on what to do in a morning routine. And I feel so far what I've figured out is that I want to do something in the morning where I am in control in the morning, where my phone is not in control of me or social media or anything of that sort. But I start my morning right away. I am focused and I'm doing things that will help me for my day. So I feel that I want to develop actually in three categories: in my physical, by physical body, in my spiritual realm, and also mentally. So I do a few things actually when I wake up, and usually on most good days, I wake up at 5:30 in the morning, and I feel like that's pretty a pretty good time because people are still sleeping, and it gives me time to really just feel like I'm doing more and I'm getting ahead of the game and I'm doing my things in the first few hours of the day that put me on track. So the first thing actually when I wake up is I go straight to the bathroom, to the toilet, and I take a freezing cold shower. So that's one of the first things that helps me both wake up, but also starts my morning routine. And of course, I get out of my comfort zone right away. So nobody wants to get up first of all at 5:30 and then go straight into the shower and turn it to cold and take a cold shower. Even me, every morning when I do it, no matter what I feel, no matter how I'm saying, no, don't do it, I still actually go in and I just do it. So cold showers are very, very good. I've done some research on them and it really helps me reduce stress levels or it increases circulation after I'm done with my cold shower. So it's like I try to do anywhere from 30 seconds to 2 minutes. If you're new to it, try 15 seconds, 30 seconds. But that's when I started. Now I do 2 minutes and I even like dance in the cold now. I'm like, I love it. So after I'm done with it, I just feel like I'm on top of the world. It boosts your metabolism. It boosts your mood. It reduces stress, as I said. It helps with weight loss. And so many, many good things. I usually do my Head and Shoulders, washing, whatever. And then after I turn it on for 2 minutes, I just focus on my breath. I kind of get grounded with myself in the shower, in the cold. And then after it's done, I just feel on top of the world. My skin is like, there's goosebumps. I feel warm actually. And I'm ready to go and tackle the rest of my day. So that's the beginning of my physical development when I wake up. So when I wake up, I do my cold shower, then I go downstairs and I do something of exercise, of a workout. So I read that in order to wake yourself up and have a good circadian rhythm, you have to do three things. So that's water, light, and movement. So water in cold shower, or I also come down, I drink a cold water. You can do it with salt, with Himalayan salt, a little bit, and lemon if you'd like, but I just do just water on its own. I make sure the light is on and I do movement, whether it's my cardio for the day or I try to do some burpees in the morning. If I'm doing a bigger exercise workout with Alicia, because usually Alicia and I do a workout together later in the day, I just do some burpees, and it can be anywhere from 15 burpees to I sometimes do 120 burpees, where I do 15, then 15 seconds rest, then 14 second rest, and all the way down to one. That's really difficult. But so that's my physical development in the morning. And then right after that, I go kind of into my spiritual development, where I do a journal of the day, and I kind of sit down and I write the date. I write a quote that kind of inspires me. I find one, I have an app. And from there, I do something with affirmations. And affirmations are really, really great. They are statements that you tell yourself, or you can write down either every day or a few times a day, to remind yourself what you are and what you want to be. And you write them in the form of I am. So some of mine are, I am healthy, I am fit, I am motivated, I am likable, things like that. So something that you really, you aspire to be and you want to be, you write it in the I am, and you try to just feel it with all of your body that yes, I am this. And I think that's when it works the most. So after I write my affirmations, whatever they are, also in with finances and money, also people like to write I am statements. After that, I write what I'm grateful for. So gratitude is huge. It's a very big thing in my spiritual development as well. So I do at least three things I write down every day that are different, that I'm grateful for that day. And it could be anything from I'm grateful for this coffee that I'm having with my significant other, or I'm grateful for my ballroom coach, Christina, because we're having this meeting and she always inspires me. And or I'm grateful for my breath and I get grounded. And so just anything that you're grateful for, whether it's the roof, the pillows on your bed, or something of your own, you just, I find that ever since I've been doing gratitude, I've actually been more motivated, but also in a more thankful and appreciative mood for everything and anything that happens, whether it goes right the way we think it is right, or whether it goes wrong. There's a reason behind whatever is happening, and you, no matter what you think, are in charge of it. So you can react to it in a way. So with my spiritual, I do my journal and my gratitude. I finish my gratitude. After that, I also do my breathing. So I close my journal, and to finish off my spiritual development, I do something called the Wim Hof method. And this ties in with a cold shower, because I learned about this. So Wim Hof is amazing. If you guys want, check him out. He's on Instagram, he's on YouTube. He has so many world records, and many, many years, a scientist actually thought that he was just superhuman, that it was just his body and that's it, that nobody else could do what he's doing. And they call him the Iceman because many of his world records, one of them including, he actually climbed Mount Everest until the summit with just his bathing suit shorts on. So no socks, no shoes, no five layers or whatever, just literally a walking stick and bathing suit shorts. It's incredible. So he really studies and teaches the mind and how you can be controlling your mind over your body with the use of breath and cold exposure. So there's something called the Wim Hof method, where you continuously breathe in and breathe out for 30 to 40 times. And you go like, it's really deep. Alicia used to hate this because when I first started doing this, I did it in the nighttime, and it's better in the morning. I learned on an empty stomach, and you have to really have a deep in and deep out right away. And it's continuous for 30 to 40 times. And what happens actually is your blood, it gets rid of the carbon dioxide. So you are able to actually retain more of the oxygen when you do that. And after the 40th time, you just breathe in, breathe out, and you stop. And you just hold your breath for as long as possible. Now, of course, when you feel like you need to breathe again, you have to breathe. But I've went from anywhere from 1 minute to now, I am around 3 minutes in retention, it's called. So 3 minutes, I don't breathe. I don't need to breathe. And at the end, those last 5, 10 seconds, when you're almost breathing and you almost have to have that breath, it is a euphoric state, and it combines both, I call it active meditation. So it combines both my breath and also my mind and my mindset. So it's a well-being all together. And I meditate, but also I feel physically like euphoric. I can't even explain it. So I just like that cold exposure, that shower, there are things rushing in my body and I feel like I'm just ready for my day. So with the Wim Hof method, I do 3 to 4 sets usually of this breathing. And after that, I feel really calm. I feel like my immune system is just roaring. I like whether I don't feel good in the morning or not, it just boosts me up. And it actually boosts energy and willpower and concentration. And I was reading all about it. So Wim Hof method is amazing. That's my spiritual. So I do my physical and my spiritual. And at the end, I do my mental development. And that is anywhere from I try to read in the morning, at least 10 pages of a book. So read. I also study French at the moment on Duolingo on my phone. So something that gets your brain active and mentally kind of takes you a step up. And then I like to also listen to some podcasts as I am either doing the workout or something to develop myself a little bit mentally. And when I'm starting my day, and then I kind of make coffee for Alicia and I and everything, I kind of try to take myself to the mental development as well. So 3 things that I try to do is the physical, spiritual, and the mental. And those are the ways that I kind of get to do that in the morning.
Nice.
Wow, that was a lot.
but a lot of information, but I think really good information. And I think one thing that I think is really important is, well, a lot of it is important, but this is gratitude, which is really a way to train yourself to focus on the positive as well. And I see that for sure in you, like you're always very positive and a very positive energy. So
it
would be because of that. Is that, how long have you been doing this?
So just the gratitude.
No, I mean, kind of the whole, that routine in general, I guess the routine obviously have changed a little bit.
Yes, of course. So the routine constantly changes, whether like I read something new and I try it or, but mostly within this kind of idea, I've been doing it for, let's say maybe around 2 years, but it's so where it just went from like in the morning I did a journal and then a workout or just a journal or something. And there were different states really, but I got to where I am with this and what I like and what my body feels and my mind feels good after doing all of this within the 2 years. So all of these things, they've just been a constant journey and an exploration within myself and what makes me well motivated, but also gives me that mindset, that motivation, that groundedness, I like to call it. And the gratitude itself, as you said, is a very, very important part of that journey. So the gratitude, I used to always kind of be grateful for the things that I have, but I never actually fully implemented it until recently. It's been maybe half a year. And in that half a year, it's been probably the most happy and the most positive happy year that I've had. And that's crazy with the times that we're in and the coronavirus and COVID and quarantine and lockdown and how we're not able to do many things, especially in England at the moment. But there's always 2 ways to think and react of something. You can be negative and just what people say realistic, which is good, but you can also be positive, grateful for what you do have, and just start with setting some goals and put them into action as well. But the gratitude really, really helps. For the past half a year, it's been a huge, huge change in me.
And I think that's so important because, of course, we cannot control the circumstances we're in, but we can control how we react to it and how we see things. And even in the most horrible, negative situation, there's always something positive to take from it and something to focus on that changes that mindset a little bit. And I think especially now, that is, of course, extra important.
Exactly. I fully agree with you on that. Yeah, so I think if you have the choice to react a certain way to anything, any situation. And I actually learned that from you, that it's the it's what you can't control that you shouldn't worry about as much. You should worry about what you can control and what you can do. And I feel like this morning routine that I have, it sets me into just a momentum of I can control. I can control my well-being. I can control my body feeling good, my mind feeling good. And that way I can control the rest of my day, even if I'm locked inside for the whole day.
Yeah, no, exactly. But I think a lot of people, they will kind of watch this and be like, well, this sounds really nice. And, you know, like tomorrow I'm going to wake up, have a cold shower. And then it gets to the morning. And I know, like, as I have this struggle, and I'm sure you feel this struggle as well. And then you kind of like think, oh, well, it's a bit cold and you want to stay in bed for a little bit longer. So how do you kind of motivate yourself to get going, to actually do it every single day?
So there, of course, will be days, as you said, where either something happened the day before or in the morning, there's something. And there are days where I don't do it. And I do feel the wrath of it. That day, it doesn't feel as flowing and as good as when I do it. But I'm very into James Clear. He's an author, and he wrote Atomic Habits. And he says something very, very interesting. And it's that if you miss one day, let it be the last day that you miss. So it's okay to miss a day, but, and he says it in better words, of course, but it's okay to miss a day as long as you do the next day. Don't make it a repetitive habit. Yeah. So a good habit is great, but a bad habit, if you repeat it many times, you'll just get into not doing it. So how I motivate myself, what really works actually is writing what I want to do the night before. So I even have it in my journal right here next to me so I can even show you. I like write it down with times and everything. So the time I wake up and then what I do, cold shower, water, movement, journal, all of that stuff, and what time I'm doing it. So when I'm going to sleep, I'm directing myself, my mind and my body into 5:30. I'm waking up and I'm going to do this, this and this and that tomorrow. And then when I do wake up, I don't have to remind myself or anything. I just know I fell asleep with the thoughts of, okay, I'm doing this and I know that my day is way better because of this, thanks to this. So I'm doing it. So the night before is a really, really good idea to just kind of focus yourself, even write down what you want to do the next morning. And then in the morning, when I wake up, I feel, and I've just recently heard this, if it takes less than 60 seconds to do what you need to do, just do it. And just do, and that really kind of affected me, because really waking up, it takes less than 60 seconds. You hear the alarm, you snooze it, and you get up and you just, what I do, I put the cover over the bed right away. So it doesn't look beautiful and inviting. And so I don't go into it right away. So I put the cover in the bed, and then I go and I start my morning shower or whatever it is that you want to do. So if it takes less than 60 seconds, do it. It's going to be worth it. And then you feel like, oh, I already accomplished getting out of bed. Then let me just accomplish my cold shower. Oh, I did my cold shower. Well, I'm feeling ecstatic. Let me do my morning routine, fully work out everything. So really, it just sometimes when it doesn't feel good is when you need it the most. Mm-hmm. And then after, when you feel good, or during, when you're kind of, when you're in that state of, ooh, this feels nice, I'm glad I did this, you're going to be thanking yourself. So think of the person that you want to be in the next year, in the next 5 years, and how you have to create that every single day and be 1% better every day. That kind of reminds me.
Yeah, that's a good reminder. And I think you're right. Like if you start overthinking, your brain automatically is you know, wired to be lazy. So yes. If you start making up excuses, how can I make her stay in bed for as long as possible? So once you have that instinct to go, it's about just doing it and not starting letting those thoughts come in. So what about, because obviously you're a dancer, so how does it like affect your dancing, or does it help your dancing? Do you use it for your dancing, or is it more an overall kind of life thing?
So in general, it's very good for overall life, for just getting better in every single way. But in my dancing, I find that my head is a little bit clearer. So when I start my practice, and when we're just stretching into just practicing on our own before we even touch, I feel like I have a good mindset, a good like motivation and kind of a direction to do what I want to do. Because sometimes when you don't have that, when you wake up, and I have it, sometimes I have it where you just wake up, you don't do it, and then you go into practice, you don't have a plan for practice, you don't have a goal, and it just feels like everything could be just a little bit better. And once you get into that, it doesn't feel as nice. So if I do start practice and I am already done with all of these great things that I checked them off on in the book, I feel like I'm on top of the world. I can be good with communicating. I could be good with leading or with whatever I'm doing today in the plan. And so really my mind and body are both ready already. So I don't have to kind of motivate myself because I'm on a roll. I'm already, momentum started. I'm already on a roll. And then with this, it's kind of, it also is very, it's just infectious. It's whether your partner feels it or people around you, whoever it is, or if you're talking to someone, it's just people notice it. And then they want to be like that too, because at the end of the day, everybody, no matter what they do, no matter who they are, they want to be better. They want to be happy. They want to be loved. So those are the basic human feelings and that we need. And so if you do this for yourself, you are doing that with love for your own self, for happiness, your own happiness, for health. And really that just, it just makes you better each time. And then you also give this off, this energy, this vibe to everyone around you. And it's just from then, it's just magic happens all around you.
No, I see it. Like, I'm sure a lot of people will be inspired by these things now. Even for me, I'm starting to think, well, how could I do this in the morning? I used to go swimming outside in the morning, so in the winter. But now, because of Corona, they don't close the sea down, but the place where I go, they close that down. So I was like, I've been a bit lazy, but you can do it in your own shower.
Was it cold? So you know cold exposure then?
It's very cold. But yeah, it's really like in and out, because your body cannot take it for very long. And then you go in the sauna and you go out again. And it's kind of, it's a great, I love doing it. But it's because of obviously Corona at the moment, is they've closed down the sauna. So they closed the whole space down. And I haven't really been doing it. But why not just do it in your own shower?
Exactly. You can do it in your own shower. And that's the beauty of it. You can do it anywhere. You can all of these things. Even if I were to be quarantining in a hotel room right now, you usually have a shower and you have some space. That's, you can do a morning routine anywhere and in any single circumstances. And of course, you can cater it to yourself and whatever you feel good with. You don't have to do all of this crazy stuff, or you can do even crazier stuff. So it's all based on you and what makes you happy and feel good.
Yeah, and I think that's important to just, you can kind of start off slow. So you can say, okay, just tomorrow I'm going to start off by waking up at this time and having this cold shower, or maybe writing in my gratitude journal or whatever, and just starting with little steps to get you to that point, because obviously it also took you some time to get to that point. And we don't,
of course,
say, okay, tomorrow I'm going to wake up and have a 1.5 hour morning routine. That might be a little bit too much to start with, but start with little goals, and then once you start feeling the benefits, for sure you will, you know, increase that, and it will get easier and easier, because you also see what effect it has on you when you're not doing it.
Exactly. I completely agree with you. So, and you can start very, very small with all of these things, because I did as well. I got up to this. And really, one of the things that are very important is to show up every single time. So just, even if you are doing one of the things that we've mentioned, or all of them, if you do it for 10 seconds or 30 seconds or 60 seconds, that is still showing up. Mm-hmm. And you create that little good habit of, I did this, even if it was 30 seconds, I did this. And then of course it's going to, you know, with time, you're going to do it for longer and longer, and until, you know, you feel comfortable. And, but it's showing up. And people usually say that it takes anywhere from 21 days to 33 to 90 to create and stick to a habit. So I think it's better to do less. So 30 seconds or a minute or 10 minutes of whatever you want to do, but every single day, than just do like 1.5 hours tomorrow, and then it was so much, your body's not used to it, you're not used to it, the next day you kind of fall off of it. So it's better to go little by little and show up and just do it, get it done, and then you feel great, and then you see how you can amend it afterwards.
Well, I think this has been very inspirational, and I'm sure a lot of people will be kind of inspired to do more to help their well-being. So thank you very much, Yuri, for talking about what you do every morning.
Thank you so much for letting me talk. I love this. Like, I feel like I could be talking forever. So if anyone ever has any questions or doesn't know how to start, you can, of course, contact Christina or myself, and I'd be just like more than happy to help. I love this stuff.
Yeah, and if anyone kind of wants to contact you or for anything really, how can they follow you? How can they get into contact with you?
So usually Instagram is best, I think. But on my Instagram, I also have a link with my phone number and my email if you guys want to do that. But yeah, my Instagram is best. So I think.
What's your Instagram name?
So it's Furious. It's a little pun on my name. FYURIYOUS, Furious.
Perfect. I'll put it in the links as well. But just
to thank you so much. Yeah, I'm so glad I could help people and be the best thing.
Perfect. Well, have a nice day.
Thank you so much.